Hello everyone, in today's video I will show you how I created this cool double exposure effect image that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Alright, so we'll go ahead and open Adobe Photoshop, and I will take the image I will be using and open it in here. Alright, now we need to make a selection of the model, but since it's a bright image and the background also is white, I will go to adjustment and I will apply a level adjustment on it, just to darken it a little bit. So I will take these midtones in here and I will drag them into the right. And now I can make my selection, but I will make sure that I'm still on the level adjustment layer, and I will go and select the quick selection tool in here, and I will quickly make a selection of the model just like this. Alright, let me delete this level adjustment layer now, and I will go and open the select and mask, and I will take the refined edge brush, and I will try to improve the selection of the hair in here just like this. Now I will change the output to selection, and I will press OK. Alright, now I will press Ctrl J to paste my selection in a new layer, and I will delete this one in here. I will name this model. Alright, now we'll go to adjustments in here and choose solid color. I will change the color to white for now, and I will press OK. I will take it and put it under the model layer, and I will name it BG for background. Now we'll go and open the second picture I will be using. I will take it and open it in a new tab, and I will drag it to the other tab in here. Alright, let me name it Bridge. And I will put down the opacity around 50%. This way I can see where I want to exactly place it for the exposure effect. Alright, now we'll press Ctrl T to make the image smaller, just around here. And I will click on this check mark to commit the change. Alright, now we'll bring back the opacity to 100% again. Now I will select the model layer, and I will hold Ctrl on my keyboard, and I will one click on it to load the selection of the model. And then I will select the bridge layer, and I will one click on this layer mask icon to put it inside the silhouette of the model. Alright, now we'll go to the background layer, and I will double click on it, and I will sample a color from the bridge sky in here, and I will press OK. Alright, now we select the bridge layer again, and I will change the blending mode to multiply. Now I'm gonna make a copy of the bridge layer, so I will press Ctrl J, and I will take the layer mask and I will delete it, and then I will change the blending mode of it to darken instead of multiply, and I will apply a black layer mask on it. So I will hold Alt on my keyboard, and I will one click on this layer mask icon, and then I will make sure that I'm in the layer mask, and I will select the brush tool with a 40% opacity, and white is my foreground color. I will start brushing to reveal the birds. Alright, now we select the model layer, and I will make a copy of it. So I will press Ctrl J, and I will take this model copy and put it on the top in here. I will name it Highlights, and I will put down the fill to 0%. I will double click on it to open the layer style dialog, and then I will select the inner shadow, and I will change the blending mode to screen, and I will replace it like this, and I will change the size to 70 pixels, and I will press OK. Alright, now we'll go to adjustment and choose solid color, and I will choose a soft yellow color. Let me add a little bit of warm to it, just like this, and I will press OK. Alright, now we'll change the blending mode of it to multiply, and I will put down the opacity around 25%. Alright, I will go back to adjustment, and I will choose gradient map. I will open the gradients, and I will change this black to a soft red color, and I will press OK. Now I will change this white color to a soft blue color, and I will press OK. Alright, now we'll change the blending mode to soft light, and I will put down the opacity around 50%. Alright, now we'll make a stem visible layer. So we press Alt, Ctrl, Shift, E, and then I will desaturate it. So we'll go to Image, Adjustment, and choose Desaturate. I will change the blending mode to soft light, and I will put down the opacity around 50%. And that's it. So I hope that you enjoyed and liked this tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, give it a thumb up and share it, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and check out my previous video to see how I created this other double exposure effect image that you can see in here. Alright, so thank you for watching and have a nice day.